Jhansi. Perhaps no other city symbolizes valor and sacrifice as this one. This city has been immortalized in history by its great queen Rani Lakshmibai and how the people of this city rallied around her as she rose against the British in the revolt of 1857. These historic buildings and monuments in and around the city have been a witness to Jhansi's glorious past. But the story of Jhansi is layered with many pieces that come together. To trace the story of Jhansi, you have to go around 130 kilometers south to Devgarh in Lalitpur district of Uttar Pradesh. It is here, in the forests by the banks of the Betwa River, that numerous Paleolithic tools were found, which tell us that the region was inhabited since the prehistoric time. During the ancient period, Jhansi and its surrounding region was a part of the Chedi Mahajanapada, one of the 16 kingdoms and republics that existed in North India at the time. Its importance lay in the fact that it was centrally located on the Dakshinapath, the ancient trade route that connected North and South India. These remnants of the Buddhist caves, hidden in the cliffs by the Betwa River, are a remnant of those times. Here, time stands still and you can even find wild crocodiles basking in the sun. Numerous dynasties ruled Jhansi through history and each dynasty left its own mark in the region. Various inscriptions found in and around Jhansi city revealed that there was a settlement called Balwantnagar around the 10th century in the area Jhansi city stands today. The Chandela rule between the 9th and the 13th centuries was followed by that of the Khangar dynasty, who ruled from the famous fort of Garkundar, located around 42 kilometers from Jhansi city. In the 13th century, Khangar dynasty was replaced by that of the Bundelas. In the 16th century, the Bundela Rajas made Orcha, located around 12 kilometers from Jhansi, their capital, and ruled the region from here. The palaces, temples, and chhatris of Orcha are a testament to the time when it was a capital of the sprawling Bundela kingdom. It was the greatest of the Bundela rulers, Raja Bir Singh Judev, who recognized the strategic importance of the area and built a fortress on a barren hill known as Bangra in 1618 CE. It is this fortress that later evolved into Jhansi Fort and the settlement around it became known as Jhansi. Raja Bir Singh Judev divided his vast kingdom among his numerous sons and grandsons, each of whom built a seat of their own. The magnificent fort of Barwa Sagar, dominating the vast lake, the great fort of Tehrauli, and the fort of Tal Behat were all built by these Bundela princes. In 1729, when the Mughal armies attacked Raja Chhatrasal, the Maratha Peshwa Bajirao I came to his rescue. In gratitude, Raja Chhatrasal gifted Jhansi and its surrounding areas to the Peshwa, who appointed a governor here. In 1769, Raghunath Rao Nevalkar was appointed as the Subedar or the governor of Jhansi, who went on to establish the Nevalkar dynasty to which Rani Lakshmibai belonged. He extensively renovated the Jhansi fort and built the Rani Mahal, the Ganesh Mandir and the Mahalakshmi Mandir in the Jhansi city. While Nevalkars were establishing their rule over Jhansi, another powerful kingdom emerged to its north. This was the kingdom of Samthar. Originally feudatories of the Datia state, the rulers of Samthar, who were from the Bar Gurjar dynasty, allied themselves with Mahaji Sindhya and carved out an independent kingdom for themselves. Due to its strategic alliances, Samthar emerged as one of the most powerful kingdoms in Bundelkhand and employed several European mercenaries. The amazing combination of Bundelkhandi and European architecture seen in the Samthar fort is a testament to those times. Over time, Samthar kingdom also took over the fortresses of Amargarh and Lohagarh under their control. In 1842, Jhansi's last ruler, Raja Gangadhar Rao, married Manikarnika Tambe, who became known as Rani Lakshmibai. Following Raja's death in 1853, the British East India Company annexed Jhansi. The British forced the Rani to leave the Jhansi fort and move to the Rani Mahal. It is here, in this Rani Mahal, that Rani Lakshmibai lived till 1857, and it is here that the Indian fighters implored her to take over the leadership of the fight against the British. With Jhansi under their occupation, the British built a new fort known as the Star Fort in Jhansi's cantonment area. It was with the attack on this very Star Fort that the revolt of 1857 began in Jhansi. Rani Lakshmibai and Jhansi's residents fought valiantly against the British for a year before Jhansi fell to the British Army in 1858. Not just the Jhansi fort, but even the forts of Barwa Sagar and Tal Behat saw fierce battles against the British. After recapturing Jhansi in 1858, the British established a large cantonment here. Another cantonment was established at Babina and a dam was built at Sukma Dukma with a mile-long tunnel running through it. Today, Jhansi is a thriving modern city that combines the best of the old and the new. Presently, the Uttar Pradesh government, through the Municipal Corporation of Jhansi and the Smart City Project, is working on preservation of these historic monuments. Some of the projects include landscaping, restoration, and the sound and light show at the Jhansi Fort, and the restoration of the forts of Tehrauli and Barwa Sagar. Let's all get together to preserve our common heritage.